Hello friends, I'm Evil Taz, and we are back with another video of Final Fantasy XVI. Like the content, please like, comment, and subscribe. Actually getting back from vacation, and trying to get back into this, see if we can figure out what we were doing. We can remember the buttons and stuff. It's, yeah. In over a week. I haven't really done much.
Things to be changing so fast lately, I can hardly keep up. But what I do know is that there's...
I haven't been gaming, anything like that. Just chilling. Make sure we've got our potions.
Take care out there, eh?
Okay, so it's Pedaris at Martha's Rest. Anywhere here.
I've got greens of all shapes.
It doesn't still hurt, does it?
Uh-huh.
The people of the rest may seem to be in high spirits. I give them a little wine.
I have no idea where she could be.
Want to know how to tell if the world's going to rack and ruin? Look for busy blades.
Looking for shelter, are you? Come on inside. Introduce you to Martha.
In a building somewhere, maybe? Could be upstairs or around the corner from here, maybe. I think over here.
It's been a pleasure, Doris. Just like old times.
I'll give your offer some thought, my lady.
How goes the investigation?
Sid, what brings you to Martha's Rest?
You. I heard you were out here on your own, tracking our slaver. I trust you're being careful.
Of course. And it had to be me. The bearers from the Dragon's Eyrie confirmed a long-held suspicion of mine that the slaver we've been tracking is an old acquaintance. She's no fool. If we'd come in force, she would have spotted us straight away, and then vanished without a trace.
That was her just now, wasn't it? So, was it a fruitful reunion?
I'd say so. She tried to recruit me. Seems her time in Rosaria is coming to an end. She's abducted bearers from across the region and is looking to smuggle them back into Sambrek. After her brush with those beastmen on the road to Northreach, she hired herself an Imperial escort, which she wants me to join. She's dangerous, Sid, but I think I can stop her.
Then I'm going with you. I'll take care of the escort. You can see the bearers to safety. Where are they?
The Balm Arches, soon to break camp. You go on ahead. I'll follow once I've sent word back to the hideaway.
Alright, now I just gotta remember how to attack and stuff. I think L2 was switching between my icons. Going to fast travel. Right here first. Yeah, hope you guys are doing well. I'm all rested up and such. Do not remember a single thing about this game. Other than the icons and switching between them. And press square to attack.
Ah, Lord Rosfield. What brings you to Eastpool?
A delivery from Martha.
I'm sure I'll pick it up. Once we get into combat, at least. We'll all come back.
These are Gizal green seeds. Martha's keen to cut the apron strings, then, is she? I jest, of course. You see, I had thought we might be able to revive the old wheat fields. But they'd long since gone to seed. Only, without the seeds.
Martha was hoping he might be able to show the bearers how to plant and tend these, so that they'll be able to fend for themselves.
That's not a bad idea. These bearers had only recently escaped their bonds before we brought them here. They know little of freedom, of providing for themselves and their loved ones. Unless we teach them how to live like free men, I fear that all we have achieved in bringing them here is to exchange one master for another. Not that myself and the Guardians have been the best example to them so far, subsisting almost entirely on Martha's charity as we do. It's about time we all started to provide for ourselves, bearers and Guardians alike. Unfortunately, we've been a little too busy of late to focus on much besides bolstering our defenses. There have been alarming reports of...
The Horde is closing in. They're coming, so wait, all of them.
Damn it all. I thought we'd have more time. Gather the men in the square. Send to the rest for reinforcements.
Yes, Sir Wade.
The Horde.
A Kashyyyk, a veritable legion of them. They've been seen prowling around the northern reaches for a while now. We don't have the numbers to hold back a swarm that size. I had hoped to build a perimeter wall so that myself and the Guardians might be able to defend the village, but...
Now you're out of time.
Precisely. If reinforcements from the rest arrive before they do, we may just scrape through, but I fear that's rather an enormous if.
What if you could call on reinforcements from Eastpool?
You mean the bearers? We brought them here so they might live, not die, fighting for their lives.
So wait. You said you lack men to defend the village. Are the bearers not men? Do they not wish to see Eastpool saved? Though they may not be trained soldiers like your Guardians, what help they are able to offer could still prove the difference between victory and defeat.
You're right, my lord. I will appeal to them. My friends, I humbly beg your aid. We Guardians are few and our enemies many. But I swear we can defeat them with you at our side.
You would send us to the slaughter. To serve as bait for those fiends so that you and your men might be spared. And to think... We trusted you. Say what you will. A home is not worth dying for.
But it is worth fighting for. Sir Wade fights to give you lot a chance. Just like I do. Just like Sid does. We all wanted to give you a home where you could be free. And you got one, didn't you? This place, Eastpool. This is your village, your home. And if you don't fight to protect what's yours, you'll lose it. You know I'm right. This world wants to take everything from you. Everything. Your homes, your freedom, your very lives. So then, are you going to stand by and let that happen to you? Are you going to accept fate like good little Bran did and die, having never stood up for yourselves? Or will you fight like free men and women?
What are you doing?
All right. Give me a sword. I never dreamt I'd have a home of my own. And now that I have... I don't want to lose it. I will protect what's mine, or die trying.
We all will.
free men and women fighting together. For Eastpool.
For Eastpool.
Thank you, Martha.
Don't mention it. Just promise me one thing, that you'll show them how freeborn fight.
Gladly.
Well, if it was numbers you were lacking, you certainly won't be now.
Thanks to you.
Me? Oh, I just love the sound of my own voice.
Lord Rosfield, my lady, we're ready.
So what's the plan of action?
We'll divide our forces into several small detachments, each made up of guardians, bearers, and guards from the rest. These will position themselves at strategic points around the village. Upon engaging with the Akashic, each detachment will keep the creatures occupied as best they can, steadily retreating all the while.
You're going to lure them into the village?
I am. We will have neither the time nor the resources to treat the wounded, so injuries must be avoided at all costs. Instead, we will focus purely on defense at first. By coordinating our withdrawal through the use of messengers drawn from among the bearers, we will aim to have the swarm converge at a point of our choosing. With luck, that point will be the village square, the perfect place for our most able warriors to surround them and fall upon them, and for you and I to finish them off.
A sound plan, but one that'll require a leader with a cool head and strong nerves to coordinate the retreat. I'd say you have both in abundance await, but you'll be needed. Please, leave the last of the fighting to me.
Ha! And let you have all the glory.
Sir, wait! They're here!
Then you know what you must do. We work together, everyone playing their part, each shielding the other that no man might fall, that Eastpool might live on. For Rosaria!
For Rosaria!
We've no time to argue, my lord. I'll do as you ask.
And I will do as you ask.
Suppose we'd better do our bit too, then, eh?
Right you are, Martha.
The calm before the storm. And here it comes.
Hey, what do we have? Oh yeah.
Let this village fall. This one.
All right, slowly it's coming back. Damn it. Totally whiffed that. I want to grab that guy down here. There we go.
Diva!
Let's move to one side so I can actually see where they're coming from. That's right, we don't have a block. We only have the dodge. I should really heal up. I totally forgot. I was too busy trying to figure out the attacks and didn't even see my health bar. I mean, that was a strategy, I think. Yep, strategy.
Looks like that's the last of them.
Lord Rosfield, change of plan.
What is it?
Owl from the rest. An Akashic Curl's been sighted on Rhiannon's ride and is headed in their direction.
Well, the better half of her guard is here. So wait, how many Akashic remain in Eastpool?
Hard to say. My men are still facing some resistance, but I think the worst is behind us. I could order a detachment or two to fall back and...
No. Let them finish the job. You stay here too, Sir Wade. Your men need you. I'll go after the Curl. Join me only when Eastpool is won.
If you're sure, my lord. May the Founder protect you.
Okay, make for Rhiannon's? Well... might be faster to go into town. That way I can top up the two heals that I used.
What are you after?
Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be uploading multiple videos a day. Maybe after few days I might get back into it. It's just you know, I want to not really go too hardcore gaming right from vacation, you know. Wanna take it easy. So we've got a new game, Remnant 2, coming out as well. I have pre-ordered. Just waiting for it. Don't know if I'm gonna play that right away or if I'm gonna wait till I finish this and then play that. But I'll have a video up just to see how it is.
Can hardly make you.
Kind of glowing now. High stagger on that. Still coming back. come on.
To East Pool.
Lord Rosfield, the Coeurl, is it?
It's dead.
Thank the Founder for that. And for you, my lord. We were able to eradicate the rest of the Horde. I have guardians posted around the village to keep watch for further attacks, but all seems quiet for now. I hesitate to say it, but I think it might be over.
I think it might.
We did it. We saved Eastpool. Thank you, my friends. Thank you.
No, Sir Wade. It's us who should be thanking you. You brought us together. Showed us what it means to fight for what you hold dear.
We never had nothing to call our own before. We didn't know what it meant to protect it. But now we do. We really do.
Forgive us, Sir Wade. You and your people saved us. And still we doubted you. But there's no doubt in my mind anymore. We're free men now. So we have to start acting like it. We have to fight to protect what's ours. To protect Eastpool.
And we shall. We all shall. Together. This is our home. And if anyone or anything tries to take it away,
they'll have us to answer to.
Come on then. Let's get to work.
This village isn't going to rebuild itself.
They're not slaves anymore.
No. They're Osarians. Your father took pity on the bearer's plight, and I believe if he were still with us today, this is what he would have wanted.
I believe you might be right.
I shall remain here, my lord, and do what I can to help rebuild the village. After all, this is my home now, too. And I could hardly call myself an Eastpoolian if I didn't pull my weight.
I think you'll find it's Eastpoolian, Sir Wade. But you should be proud all the same. I'll have to pull my weight, too. Can't have the rest getting outclassed. Speaking of which, I ought to be getting back.
Can we continue to count on your support, Martha?
Of course, and I'd be counting on yours too. Us Rosarians have got to stick together, haven't we?
Indeed we have.
And Clive, come by the Golden Stables when you get the chance. I ain't paid you for delivering them seeds yet.
All right, I will.
Lord Rosfield. Do you remember our very first mission together? Clearing the goblins from the Stillwind Marshes?
How could I forget?
There's one sight that I shall never forget. You, facing off against that giant Morble. Not a trace of fear on your face. Since that day, there have been more than a few times when I felt like giving up. When the odds seemed so stacked in the enemy's favor, I thought I may as well just lay down my sword and surrender. But every time I would think back to the look in your eyes that day and remember what it means to be a shield. Know that whatever trials Eastpool may face, I shall never lose courage. Thanks to you.
Sir Wade, you have always been a true shield. I know that Eastpool and indeed all of Rosaria, will be safe in your hands.
Thank you, my lord. I know the rest of the world will be safe in yours.
I'll do my best.
The side missions really do drag on, don't they? anyway, let's go here, hand this in. Finish it off. And hopefully carry on the main mission.
How do?
I think I've gotten back to... I'm not 100% with everything, but I've got an idea of the controls again. A lot of dodging, timing, my attacks.
The hero returns. It's lucky you came by when you did, eh? Not only did my seeds get delivered, but you went and saved Eastpool and all.
I just did what I could.
And it's only right that you get rewarded for it. Take it, before I change my mind.
Fine, he twisted our arm.
Thank you, Martha.
So, Eastpool's finally back on its feet again. And a home to free bearers. Who'd have thought we'd see the day, eh?
Well, it was your idea.
I know that, but I never stopped to think what it would mean. Bearers in charge of themselves, thinking for themselves, working for themselves. Not your hideaway, but not even hidden away. Though I suppose the rest ain't much different nowadays. You know, bearers living free like that reminds me of when I first met Sid. Loath as I am to recall that particular day.
I take it you didn't always see eye to eye. What happened?
Well, if you really want to know, I started doing what I do long before I met Sid. In fact, that's how I met him. Or at least how he came to meet me. He showed up at the stables one day, asking questions about who'd been buying up bearers. Founder knows what he thought I was doing with them. Running a hunt, poking around in their innards. Something awful anyway. Me, I thought he was a new constable. Thought the game was up. But somehow we both managed to work out what each other was about. And before I knew it, the cheeky arse was rattling on at me about how I was doing it all wrong. After all my hard work. Told me I was giving them relief, but not freedom. That my bearers were still dying as slaves. Got right under my skin, it did. Told him if he didn't like it, he could bugger off and report me to the garrison. And do you know what he did? He smiled. And then he laughed. And then I did the same. We made a pact that day that whenever one of us was in need, the other would always be there for him.
And you were?
Well, we both wanted the same thing, to make life better for bearers. Just like your dad. Do you know I was born right around the time Elwyn became Archduke? Growing up, I saw how he tried to change things. He certainly didn't lack for ambition, that one.
Indeed. But the loftier one's ambitions, the harder they are to achieve. Which is why those of us who follow in their footsteps need to finish what people like Sid and my father started.
Suppose you're right, aye. And if we don't manage it, there's always them who come after us. Good thing we've got a few half-decent sorts waiting in the wings, eh? It's almost enough to give you a little bit of hope.
Just a little.
Anyway, enough nattering. Better get back to work. Let's see about making everyone some dinner, shall we? The least the folks who saved Eastpool deserve is a hot meal. And you and me ain't gonna save the world on an empty stomach neither.
That sounds like a wonderful idea.
Geez, finally. Less chit-chat, more giving me the rewards. Letting me fight again. So figure things out. Alright, we got the signboard. Now we are traveling. That's too far away over here.
Let's just
pop up. Yes.
Ambrosia won't help me here.
Why not? Switch over to this. That's right. All the crappy loot around the world. Not really helpful. Just over here, might as well grab it. There's enemies there as well though, right? Not.
Long enough. She's not coming. Ready the bearers. We're leaving.
Back to civilization, is it, Mom?
With all haste, lest any of you lackwits start talking like these feckless bumpkins. I presume your men are ready. We've suffered too many delays as it is. Any more, and I'll be docking your pay.
Yes, Mom.
Oh, but before you go, it appears we have company. Kill him.
You're welcome to try. All yours, Thorvald.
Over here. Ah, damn it. Around. I think I got it too early. That's what I needed. Coming back just like I played it yesterday, and we were on the hunt for AP, I believe.
So much for your escort.
You'll forgive me for not avenging my men. I'm not the swordswoman I used to be. I surrender. Do with me as you wish, Sid the Outlaw.
Sid!
Ah, Doris. I take it you're not here to rescue me from our brooding renegade. You know, I always wondered where you'd vanished to. But casting your lot with this criminal of all people.
Better fighting for a cause than killing for coin. I'm sorry, Sid. I should have told you sooner. This woman, my former master, once trained bearer children to be weapons in service of the highest bidder. She raised me like a daughter, and I did terrible things to earn her favor.
It wasn't all terrible, surely. We had our fun, too. You were always so eager to learn, and had such clever hands. All my other children took either to the blade or to the books. Always either or. But you
proved yourself a master of both. That's why I kept you for my own. How about it, my little dagger? Care to swear that blade to me again?
I never swore my blade to you, nor will I ever. I fight for a higher cause, to liberate the bearers of this world. Farewell, master. Thank you for making me the weapon I am.
You always were a righteous child. Perhaps that's the reason I loved you so.
What do you want to do with her?
I am not the killer she wanted me to be. Not anymore. And she no longer has friends in high places. The dame does, though. Her connections at the Imperial Court will see that justice is done.
All right. If you're certain.
I am. And thank you for everything. Now, I better let these bearers know that they're safe.
Then I should head back to the hideaway and put Cole's mind at ease.
Yes, we should head back to the hideaway. We just end up there? We have to fast travel ourselves. Oh, we end up there.
Welcome back, Sid. Doris's message just arrived. I hear you saved more bearers from being smuggled across the border.
With any luck, they'll be joining us in the hideaway shortly. Oh, and your letter. You don't need to worry about Doris anymore.
I'd been hoping as much. She mentioned one or two things in her report. So the slaver we'd been chasing all these months was her former master. Wish I'd known. She's been arrested, by the way, over in Sambrek. Went quietly, or so we're told. And she won't be getting off lightly. The Empire may have no love for bearers, but it's none too fond of black market traders either. Can't have been easy for Doris.
I'm sure it wasn't. But don't worry. She'll be all right.
I hope so. Suppose you should know, eh? You had quite the pass yourself before you came here, or so I understand. Anyway, thanks again, Sid. The Cursebreakers would be lost without Doris. And you, of course.
Keep up the good work, Cole.
Sweet. I'm glad we did the other quest first. Gives me a trip. Have a look. The map. One potion down. Not bad. That's right. I think I did a couple of videos where I just focused on the side missions, but we are all side missioned out. And we've got Renown. Is it Renown?
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Come to claim your just desserts.
Yeah, Renown. 2,500 ability points.
There you are. All done?
Perfect. Now, the question is... what am I saving up for? Oh, that's right, I want a Giga Flare. And this one. And we'll get this one. Now, which one do I want to switch? I don't want to keep that for AoE. I like that one for good forwards AoE. This. That one does good stagger damage. I'm gonna swap this one out. A Giga Flare. So we got two skills that are on big cooldowns. Wondering if I should put the big cooldowns on where. And well, it'll be fine.
How are you feeling, Joshua?
Better than I was.
But not nearly as well as you should be. Your cuts and burns may have healed, but your body still bears the burden of every spell cast.
And what would you have had me do? It was no ordinary foe we faced. It was the Warden of Darkness. Yet still, it was not enough. The King could have ended me at any moment, but instead chose to toy with me like a curl does a mouse.
You underestimate yourself.
Oh, it was crystal clear. Only one man established his dominance that day, and that man was Barnabas. I'm sorry, brother. That was ill-spoken. It's just, I have never felt so powerless. And when so many are looking to us for strength, perhaps the prince feels the same.
What is this place?
Don't move. It's fresh from the well. Grandmother told me spirits sometimes get lost, and that the lanterns guide them to their proper place. I set one on the river for her when she passed away.
Fiend works from the shadows. Was it you who guided my hand then, Ultima? No, not you. This is my doing, my fault, my sin to bear. And for it, I must atone.
Your hurts are healing nicely. It was my poultices that saw you well.
You make them?
And sell them, or try to. Earns me enough for bread, most days.
Forgive me. I have nothing to...
I know, but I couldn't just leave you lying there. You're going then?
Of course. I'm healed. Thanks to you and your poultices.
Will you promise to come back and visit?
Phoenix, it would seem that I owe you my wings.
Perhaps he can find an answer. You will be returning to Walud soon, I gather.
I see no reason to wait.
Then neither do I.
I can think of a few, but I doubt they'll stop you. You will take your medicine.
Of course, Lady Tyre.
Set on leaving already, are you?
How long will it take us to get back to Ash?
Dunno, about the same amount of time it took us to get here. Maybe less, if your uncle can find someone trustworthy to patch up the Enterprise. All depends on where we're putting into port, mind.
Yes, it's not as if we can put ashore wherever we choose. We have to assume that the whole of Ash is hostile, and that we'll be attacked on sight.
Then we must find a place they won't think to look. And I have an idea who might know of one.
The Professor! I'll go and tell you, come in!
While you're plotting our course, I'll be in the shelves with your lawsman. I wish to pick his brains about Ultima.
Then I'll talk to Karen about supplies for the journey. They may not be easy to come by in Ash.
Your brother's body won't take much more of this recklessness. You know that, don't you?
I do.
Hey, speak with Vivian Ninetail. Give us a view of the mission, I guess.
I still say it were a compliment.
Ah, Clive. I was wondering when you'd arrive. Please tell me you've come to take our young prodigy here off my hands.
I'm not here for Mid. I need information on Ash.
Then why not ask Molly if you can look in one of her ovens? Go on.
As soon as the Enterprise is ready, we'll be setting out for Drake's Spine. And we're going to need a safe place to land.
Preferably one that won't see my ship blown to shit and splinters.
If it were that easy, do you think Walud would have resisted invasion for so long? Very little is known of Ash, and the information we do have is spotty and outdated. We have the good King Barnabas to thank for that. Walud's borders have been closed to outsiders since the day he seized the throne. If there is anywhere safe to land, you won't find it on my map.
And tell us what we will find. I'm sure you know better than we do.
But no splinters!
All right. If it will get you out of my hair. But interrupt me, and it's over. Understood? Barnabas Tharm. The one they call the Last King. Understand him, and you will understand the kingdom of Walud. Barnabas was only a boy when he arrived from beyond the southern seas, and barely a man before he united the ragged tribes of Ash. And having unleashed them upon the formidable Veldemark, He set his throne upon the ancient kingdom's ruins. The victory sent shockwaves around Valisthea. Tales of Odin's might spreading through every court, parlor, and drinking hall in the realm. Note that this was in the year 843, and that the king still sits upon his throne some 40 years later, quite untouched by time. Walud's recent inaction left many wondering if Odin had lost his appetite for war. And yet here we are. The Einherjar was committed to the fray, a bold declaration of intent. Orcs swarm around Drake's Fang, and throngs of Akashic haunt canvas streets. Though how precisely the havoc they wreak serves Walud remains unclear. Regardless, if the order to attack truly came from King Barnabas, then one thing is certain. Walud has achieved the impossible, and made bedfellows of beastmen and the Aether-addled alike. All of which is a roundabout way of saying that you will be in unknown territory when you set foot on Ash. Much of the continent has already been lost to the Blight, and what few ports remain will be fiercely guarded. And that is to say naught of its natural defenses. Offshore currents will cast an ill-equipped ship out to sea one moment, and dash it against the rocks the next. But then the Enterprise is anything but ill-equipped, and Mid has made land there before. Now, if only there were someone with an intimate knowledge of the Shadow Coast, and where a daring gentleman might put ashore. You see, Clive, you had the answer all along.
Do you think you can get us back to that beach, Mid?
Picked you up from it, didn't I? Not that it were easy. The currents were a rape bastard. But then, if it wasn't hard, it wouldn't be worth doing, would it?
Well said. Thank you, Lady Vivian.
If a few morsels of common knowledge and a sprinkling of tavern talk are worthy of your thanks, I wonder what genuine intelligence might earn me.
Probably more visits. Mid, I need everyone in the ale hall now. I'll fetch Joshua from the shelves.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Aye, aye, Captain. To the shelf.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lot of them.
Might as well stop off at the store and the blacksmith. I just remembered the blacksmith has upgrades and such.
Still alive, are ya?
Coin purse weighing you down.
Cannot find a better price than that.
The stew's all...
There was a sword I think I wanted to actually get.
Well, thanks for it, dear.
Wanted to make this. Which I think is the best sword you can get in your first place. Whatever.
Fine.
Want to carry on with the main mission again? A little bit.
I have no reason to assume.
Clive, you must listen to this. Rosman, tell him.
Do you recall when we spoke before on the divinity of Ultima? Well, it inspired me to delve deeper into the subject. And what I discovered appears to agree with the findings of His Grace.
You will recall that my quest to uncover Ultima's origins began with the mural at Phoenix Gate. But while I've always known it to be important, its secrets have heretofore eluded me. Now, however, I believe I know where to find a more complete example, one that will reveal all we seek.
Master Clive, have you ever in your travels chanced to hear of the Circle of Malleus? I would think not, if you have. But there was once a time when the faith flourished, the oldest known religion in the Twins, and though its popularity eventually waned on Storm, hints of its dogma remain embedded in more modern faiths such as the Crystalline Orthodox.
Wait, you said it waned on Storm. What of Ash?
Religious monuments are often torn down or repurposed when new faiths rise to prominence. But if no new faith arose, then perhaps the ancient temples might still stand. And so, you see now why I must accompany you to Walud.
It would appear the past still has much to teach us, though in this case, it would not have been possible without the musings of Moss. To think that you carried a copy of my old mentor's chronicles all along. I am relieved to discover it in good hands.
I shall guard it with my life.
Joshua, if you're finished here, join me in the ale hall. I need to speak to everyone before we leave.
Right away.
I could ride the Enterprise.
To the ale hall.
My apologies.
By now you've all heard where we're going and why. So I won't bother you with the boring details, only the important ones. If we attempt to approach Stone here by sea, there's a good chance we'll be sighted and fall prey to the capital's artillery. So instead, we'll disembark on the southwest coast and make for Drake's Spine on foot. I say we, but it's highly likely the entirety of Ash is under the rule of Ultima. A large party would only attract unwanted attention, as well as slow our march and require supplies, which may be difficult to obtain. Only Joshua and I will be going. And a scout. Preferably a good one. Gav, do you know of any?
You bet your ass I do. Might still borrow some of Lady Vivian's maps, though. Just in case, like.
Once you've dropped us off at the Shadow Coast, you need to retreat into neutral waters. Fly merchant colors and stay inconspicuous. If you sense any danger at all, you leave us behind and return to Storm.
Inconspicuous is my middle name. But like hell am I leaving anyone behind. The ship ain't going nowhere till your scurvy mugs are smiling on deck.
Jill, the Enterprise will appear a tempting target for Royalists and Pirates alike. You're to stop anyone boarding.
Don't worry. I'll keep the ship and her crew safe. You'll be needing passage home, after all.
But very well.
If there are no questions, I'll see you all at the docks.
Let me know when you're leaving. I want a word before you go.
Of course.
Good auto, I guess that's the last thing we gotta do. A side mission there though. Kinda want to get that sword before we carry on. Might have to look up where the fastest way to get all the opponents are. I don't know, I'll think about it. Go grab this side mission. While I think about it.
Please, you're great. So stay strong. Ah, my Lord Marquis.
Phoenix, heal thyself.
Your companions are kind indeed. I must admit, but I see now. It was the greatest honor of my life. But now, so I bid you.
Yote, is anything the matter? You seem troubled. Perhaps I might be able to help.
My lord. Yes. Perhaps you might. It's your brother. His condition continues to worsen, though he does his best to hide it. The lesion on his chest pains him more with each passing day.
I had feared as much.
There are certain elixirs which can ease the suffering of those afflicted by the curse, but...
But?
But his grace's case is severe. The drafts I have been able to prepare for him thus far have ceased to have any real effect. So I consulted with Talia and certain of my comrades among the Undying about the possibility of finding something stronger. And thankfully, a recipe was found. The only problem being that the critical ingredient is exceptionally hard to come by, and our supplies are almost exhausted. Unless we can secure more soon, your brother's anguish will likely become unbearable. My lord, I know that I have no right to make demands of you. But would you help? For Joshua's sake.
Sure.
For Joshua. Anything.
Thank you, my lord.
So, what is this critical ingredient?
A rare herb by the name of stonerwort. It grows only where the ether is densest. The vigor it stores in its stems helps to counteract the curse. We discovered a patch near the aqueduct in Rosaria. But alas, yet more ether has erupted from the earth there recently, leaving the whole area flooded. The search continues for a new source. One that we might reach without being turned.
So it's only that you can't reach it? The stonerwort itself is unharmed by the flood?
Well, yes, but...
Then I shall go in your stead.
But, my lord...
You've yet to find another source, correct? So for now, the aqueduct is our best hope. Besides, I'm a dominant. The ether can't hurt me.
Well, if you're sure, my lord, stonerwort is easily identified by its blood-red blooms. Search around the aqueduct, and you're sure to find some soon enough. I shall remain here and prepare the other ingredients.
Hey, let's have a look. Oh, we're back here at Martha's Rest again.